since our video is going to be in audio. Most of it is going to be in video, but you won't really see me that much. So that's why I got it in audio video. Now, the reason why I'm doing this for the third time is pretty much because I don't have enough storage on my phone, and the hiatus is over, and I wanted to, you know, finish the story from Morpher series now. I'm going to finish the story from Morpher Part 4 by quickly talking about number 3, and Jeannie's going to talk about number 2. Now, I said in the last video that I was going to finish Cyan Cube, and like weeks ago, I already did finish it, but I wanted to save it for the hiatus, so here it is, in the video I just showed you. Well, it's a little clip. The real pilot is like a minute and a half long. Now, I don't want to risk losing footage like I did in my original completed top 5 list, the first top 5 list I ever made, which was my top 5 lost and deleted scenes on my channel. Now, I don't want it to be like that. I really don't. But this is how my show usually is, you know. Oh my gosh, I'm running out of things to say. All I want to do is just start the video, quickly end it, and then finally I can get things back running. Something, so I'll give you what you wanted, which is this video. So I write Ivy as a writer 2, and I hope you pretty much like the video. And here it is, Story of a Morpher, Part 4. Happy birthday, Zach is on this list, because sight, it might look like an average birthday episode with the same birthday type plots where everyone pretends to forget someone else's birthday, but no, this episode is actually good because of the jokes and the seriousness in general, and I actually like the Billy jokes here too. I even like how a Trini translates them, like all that scientific music and performer type stuff, Trini translates it into he likes the music. And the cartoon illustrations, blah blah blah, science theme, Trini translates as she draws a good cartoon. Most of these scientific facts are really just compliments to Trini, and that's pretty nice. And another thing happens, including Rita saying, oh, I don't know, a monster down to destroy the Rangers and potentially destroy the planet. But this monster is Nasty Knight, who actually destroyed the planet and the planet's greatest warrior. He sends it down, she sends it down to fight Zack on his birthday. Zack is determined to win since, well, that's his birthday. However, he's not doing very good, so he needs some help from his friends, and that's when this happens. Along with being really funny, Trick or Treat is at number 2 because of, well, basically the jokes, really. I mean, a pumpkin monster that can only be waken up by a bad breath, and along with that, a monster The monster just grabs that too. In fact, half of this episode is Kennedy creeping on a Halloween themed show called Trick or Treat. Yeah, the title of this episode. However, Tommy Oliver can't really watch it because he has a karate tournament he has to go to, and he doesn't want to miss it. Truly doesn't want to miss it either. But, due to the monster appearing, Tommy has to get out there and help the Rangers, and Kimberly has to help too. And during the game, I'll tell you the truth, Vulcan Skull, the character is actually the least likely like in the show, are basically cheating in the game and they get their comeuppance at the end. Anyway, I'll talk to you guys next episode where I go training with the genie.